Hi, welcome back. There's definitely a growth slowdown. There is still a liquidity crisis, and you can see that in a whole host of stocks today. But one company that we're going to chat with right now is Ujjivan. So let's find out what's happening on the ground there. Samit Ghosh, the Managing Director and Chief Executive Officer of Ujjivan Small Finance Bank, joins us now to tell us how business is faring in this tough growth environment. Samit, thanks for joining us. At a time when there is a big rural slowdown underway, your disbursements have been growing, albeit at a lower growth rate of what we've seen before, but growing nevertheless. What's the situation on the ground now, and what would the outlook be?
So, our overall microfinance, if you see, the whole industry has grown very robustly in the last quarter, and it still continues to grow that way. There are pockets, obviously, in the rural area because of drought and things like that, flood, etc., which are affected, but the rest of the areas are totally unaffected. And as required by RBI, we've opened a number of unbanked rural branches, and they are doing absolutely fine, but we have selected these branches in areas which are not that affected by this thing, other than in Odisha, a couple of branches were affected by the cyclone Fani.
Okay. Mr. Ghosh, good morning. Thank you very much. I'm coming back to the state of the economy questions and state of your sector. But first up, you and Equitas and all of you were, I thought, in conversation with RBI whether you want to list both the NOHFC, which is already listed, and the bank. What is the status of...
So, Lata, that discussion has still not happened. It's going to happen this month.
Okay.
Sometime later this month.
Okay.
As far as there's not been change since I last talked to you. The only good thing is, governor obviously has reposed a lot of faith on small finance banks because he's kept small finance bank on the tap alive.
Yes.
And he expects, I think, a number of applications, probably the cooperative banks to apply for a conversion to small finance bank.
I agree.
And the guidelines of that will be issued in August.
Yeah.
So we are hoping to give some feedback to the RBI in terms of whatever revisions have to be made from the original guidelines. But that is, very heartening because, very frankly, that shows that RBI has, feels that we've been successful. We've been successful, but I think acknowledgement from RBI is very,
No, I completely agree with you. Actually, that was a big positive in the monetary policy statement that just went by, that they have reposed, they actually expressed their happiness over the way in which small finance banks have panned out, and they're going to put the licenses on tap. Certainly a very big positive. But, they were, we broke the story that they're going to put out a discussion paper on the non-operative financial holding company issue, which is, a different problem for small finance banks, different problem for the big banks, different problem for the Bandhan IDFC guys. So, can you enlighten us on when is that paper and should we expect?
Yeah, we've not heard much about that paper still. But as you said, it's a wider problem. It's not just with a small finance bank.
Okay.
So I think that process is still going on.
Okay. Now, what is
we
your
We have
bet?
A meeting later on and, with RBI specifically, both Equitas and us.
Okay.
And we will be discussing it with them and see how... obviously, one thing, Lata, it looks like we have to meet the licensing guidelines in terms of listing the bank, but also we want to figure out or discuss with them how we can protect the shareholders of the holding company, through a process.
Okay. So you will discuss reverse merger or things like that with the holding company?
Yeah, I think on the reverse merger issue, they're still open, obviously they can't give us a sort of go ahead right now, but they're still open that at the end of 5 years, they will certainly look at it.
Okay. Coming back to the business then, Samit, the customer acquisition has reached a record high this time around. Where are you gaining market share from? Is it from banks? Is it from NBFCs? And what would the trajectory look like?
So I think, you know, the I wouldn't say it is from the banks. Maybe to a certain extent because, you know, because of funding issues, NBFC MFIs have slowed down a bit. That could give us an opportunity. In housing, specifically affordable housing, we have seen a big growth. Again, because the housing sector has slowed down with all the problems they are facing. And that gives us definitely an opportunity.
Okay. Mr. Ghosh, will margins and spreads improve? Cost of money has come down, no?
Right. Our operating costs are still very high, you know. So yeah. We are working on trying to bring down our operating costs this year significantly, you know, because we've made all the investments. Most of our branches are converted, only 50 are left. So we are working on our operating costs. Yeah.
Okay. All right. We will leave it at that. Mr. Ghosh, it's always a pleasure speaking with you. Thank you very much for joining us. So, it's, I think, 50-50. They are going to meet RBI. But it looks like we will have to list is what he left us with.
Yeah.
We have to see whether the meeting will allow a postponement or change.
Exactly. So, for now, the stock is down about 2%.
Yes. Bank, by the way, is down 10% right now and almost, about 4.5 crore
yeah, Yes Bank is
being traded.
Yeah, Yes Bank has been down since morning, of course. But IndusInd is also now extending its losses. So obviously, this 52-week low is now gone for Yes Bank. Indiabulls Housing, though, is recovering quite a bit from the low point. It's recovered about 5%. But anyway, the problem is Yes Bank and IndusInd Bank both dragging the market. And look at Infosys now. Just see the intraday chart on Infosys. That's also down, in fact, in trade today, down about 1.5%. And HDFC as well, a bit soft. Ashwini Gujral and Mitesh Thakkar back with us. Rajat Bose is also here. Ashwini, yesterday's low is gone. Thoughts now on how to approach the index and what are the stocks that you're trading right now?
Well, it's clear there is big follow through and market breadth is already 400 to 1000. So my sense is that today could be a big day because 30,800, 850 on Bank Nifty as well as 11,800, 850 on the Nifty. That looks precarious and the market is gaining momentum with every passing minute. So my sense is that today you could get 300-400 downside on the Bank Nifty, maybe 100 plus on the Nifty. So even now, if you are going short, I think the way the market is collapsing, and that is the right word because it's not only financials, it's not only Reliance, not only mid caps, but other stocks are also coming down fairly strongly. And maybe even the range could be in a bit of trouble. Having said that, HPCL is a buy with a stop of 300, target of 321. Yes Bank is a sell with a stop of 128, target of 120. And IndusInd Bank is a sell with a stop of 1520, look for targets of 1460.
Okay, I just want to point out that Punjab National Bank is the other one that's starting to fall now. In this UBS report, they also speak about how the exposure to non-investment grade companies is very high, even for Punjab National Bank. Their analysis suggests that 20% of loans for Punjab National Bank has an exposure to these networks of banks that we cover. Along with Yes Bank and IndusInd Bank, Punjab National Bank is the other one that is pointed out in this report. But Mitesh Thakkar and Rajat Bose are also with us. Mitesh, your thoughts on how to approach these banks? Yes Bank has now 5 crore shares being traded on the downside with a 10% knockdown. Yes, IndusInd, how would you approach them? And what would be your top picks right now?
So Yes Bank, I think, you know, with the gap down today also broke that 134 low, 33 level, which was acting as an important support zone. Having seen that level go, I think the next area of support comes only around levels of 1112. So I think there could be still about roughly 10% downside from the current market price, despite the fact that today the stock is down 9% already. So I wouldn't be trading that on the long side. I think, you know, maybe buying put options at the money, put options may not be a bad idea. Same, I think, outlook on IndusInd Bank. could head towards 1400 levels next, though the downside would be slightly lesser than the S-Bank, but I think the charge structure is definitely weak. The stock calls that I have right now are a sell on CET. That's a stock, you know, which is kind of broken down, so keep a stop at about 960, look for 914 as the target, while CESC has come to support level, so I would attempt a long here. Look at a stop at about 744 and 780-85 should be your target zone.
Okay, just looking at a couple of more names, Vedanta, Tata Motors down quite a bit. And if you're looking at the futures prices, just see the way some of these stocks are now collapsing. DHFL 12.5% gone. Jet Airways also 12.5%. These are all futures rate right now. Reliance Capital 7%. Suzlon 7%. So these are some of the names where you're seeing quite a bit of selling pressure. Mitesh, PSU banks, anything that stands out? Sonia just pointed out PNB. That's collapsing right now, down 5%.
Anuj, in fact, PNB has been a sell call for the last 3 days. The stock was not falling, but it was not even getting past 80. And I think today it's kind of triggered a fresh round of selling. I think it should head towards 71. That's the first target. And 71 to about 70 should be the first target. In case that level is broken, then 65 is also a possibility. The structure remains weak, so clearly trading on the short side. In fact, yesterday's low could be the stop loss for trading, taking a short position immediately right now.
Okay. Let me welcome Rajat Bose as well to the conversation. Good morning, Rajat. What are you trading?
Good morning, Lata. I'm trading actually three stocks, out of which two are buy calls. I mean, pretty surprising otherwise. But I found that TCS and Indigo are actually bucking the trend. TCS is holding out. I would pull a stop loss below 2258 because this is in today's session, this stock will act as an index management stock. And I've kept a target of 2310 because that's the target for this upswing. And Indigo is showing a lot of strength. I would put a stop loss below 1674. 1712 is the target. I'm giving June futures targets. And the lone sale call I have is on Maruti. I would put a stop loss above 6872, 6792 and 6733 are the two targets. I would suggest the short position be carried over because I'm expecting a large fall in the market as well as auto stocks again going into Friday and Monday. So chances are that the index might shed about, I'm talking about the Nifty index, might shed about 200 or plus points. So Maruti actually might crack it once again.
Okay. I just want to point out now that if 11,850 is sacred, that has gotten pierced at this point. Does that change things for you, Mitesh?
Sorry, can you repeat that?
11,850, I thought that was a line in the sand that has gotten pierced. Is it important?
Lata, I am actually looking at 11,750, 780 as the support zone, and I think that should be tested. We last time had this correction on the 7th of June and kind of bounced back from 11,770. I think getting on the upside, 11,750 was a tough level, and I think that should act as the key support pivot.
What about you, Ashwini? Is this significant technically? Now 11,840 on the Nifty.
See, the issue is not the level. The issue is the way the market is coming off, what is leading it lower. So this is basically a collapse. 40 points will be half an hour chicken feed for this market, because once we are coming off of 12,000 with big strong momentum, I don't think this market will stop very easily. My sense would be that now we should look at lower levels, maybe 11,750, 800 even today.
Okay, well, one more stock. Our colleague Nigel points out that NMDC is down about 5% because operations at their Chhattisgarh mines have been shut for the past couple of days, and 70% of their sales comes from Chhattisgarh mines itself. So that's the reason why NMDC is under pressure.
The story in the market is this one. Yeah. DHFL, the Reliance Group, in the sense Reliance Capital, Reliance Home, and Reliance Power as well, if you please, but that's a penny stock. And allied to that, Yes Bank and IndusInd Bank. So it is this group of six, handful of stocks, which is troubling. It is the core of the trouble. and that's keeping the market, dragging it down to its knees, as it were. We'll have to wait and see. This is not a good sign.
The issue is, a lot of, there are a lot of people on Twitter and, asking, for example, last 2 days, 3 days, is it now time to buy Yes Bank? Is it now time to buy, some of these troubled names like gen irrigation? I think the market's given you enough answers. There's absolutely no bottom in some of these stocks once they start to fall. I think today's problem, though, is that even some of the relatively good quality stocks are falling. I think that's when, the trouble would be. You saw that yesterday as well. But it's a bit of a contagion which is playing out.
Axis is
right
now the only bank standing in the green.
Yeah.
And that too, 1 rupee. So it's not looking good. Okay. Thank you very much, Ashwini, Mitesh, and Rajat, for giving us trade Z10. But now we have...
Yes, in fact, just on this news flow on NMDC, it's down about 5.5%, as we mentioned. My colleague Nigel is here to tell you about that big shutdown in their Chhattisgarh mine. Nigel, 5.5% lower now.
Well, that's right, Sonia. You know, it's not good news at all for NMDC. We saw in the last few days, though part of the operations were shut down, the stock didn't really react. Now the problem is that it's a shutdown and Chhattisgarh accounts for nearly around 70%. Of their total sales for FY19. So clearly it's come as a negative surprise because the remainder of the 30% comes in from Karnataka. And out of that, we already know that the Donamalai mine has been shut down since November 2018. Let's give you a couple of numbers then and exactly why this particular shutdown has come about. Now remember, there was a deposit 13. That is another mine not included in the sales numbers till now. That would have got commissioned in the next couple of years. The locals out there and the tribes out there, they have been alleging that in fact, Adani Enterprises has been given the mine development of that deposit 13. And they have been protesting for the last couple of weeks. Now they have protested in such a manner that these two mines as well, that's the other Chhattisgarh mines that are already in production, they have absolutely been shut down. So clearly it's negative because as of now, there's only one mine of NMDC that's functioning. That's a Kumaraswamy mine in Karnataka. And besides that, half of Karnataka mines have been shut down, as well as Chhattisgarh mines have been shut down. We'll wait by to hear from the management, but for the time being, this is clearly a negative surprise for NMDC.
Okay, well, there's no dearth of bad news in today's market for sure. We'll take a quick break on that note. Thanks, Nigel, for joining us. Up next, Vimal Kejriwal, the MD and CEO of KEC International, will join in. They had an investor day held yesterday, so we'll find out what the key takeaways were.